This video is going to detail how to perform a general vacuum filtration. So we have everything we need here to set up our apparatus. We're going to begin by putting a clamp, attaching a clamp to our ring stand. That's going to secure our vacuum filtration flask so that we don't knock it over. So secure that, get it nice and straight. Now we're going to put our vacuum filtration flask into the clamp. Tighten that up. And now we can go ahead and attach our vacuum tubing. So we're just going to attach that to the arm of the vacuum filtration flask. And then the other end is going to go onto the water aspirator in the lab. So attach that to the water aspirator, and then we're ready to go. So we'll take our Buchner funnel, make sure that we have that black vacuum adapter on there. Put our Buchner funnel into our filtration flask. And now we are ready to put our filter paper on top of the Buchner funnel. We'll just set that on top. Now we are ready to wet the filter paper. So we're going to turn our vacuum aspirator, our water aspirator, on full blast. And we're just going to pour some water over the filter paper to wet it. And that's going to create a very good seal so that none of our solid ends up filtered through. So you want to swirl your beaker that has your solid in it, agitate everything, and then just pour it over. You want to pour it toward the middle of the filter paper, that way that your solid doesn't get sucked underneath it. You can use a spatula to help aid in transferring the solid over. So just again, put that into the center of the Buchner funnel. You can use a bit of cold water to help transfer any additional remaining solid from the beaker over if necessary. And then you want to spread the solid out so that we can get maximum vacuum through those crystals and get them dried. At this point, we want to make sure that we wash our crystals, and we're going to do that with some cold solvent. You want to measure probably no more than 5 milliliters for this washing step. It's really important that we use cold solvent here so that we do not dissolve any of our crude sample. So take about 5 milliliters. Then you're going to just pour that over the top of your solid. You want to make sure that you are spreading that liquid out, so pour it over all of the crystals if at all possible. And at that point, after you've poured the water over, again you're going to want to take a spatula and spread those crystals out and agitate them. That's going to once again maximize the vacuum that's coming through our crystals to get them dry. We're going to detail how to do a recrystallization in this video. So we have our recrystallization solvent on a hot plate. It is clamped to a ring stand, and so it is in a beaker with a watch glass on top. It's important to have this clamped so that we don't accidentally knock it over and send solvent flying. We want to turn the hot plate on to a very low setting. We are using ethanol in this particular recrystallization, so between 2 and 3 will do just fine. So now we have our solid that we are recrystallizing in a beaker. And we have a glass transfer pipette with a bulb on top of it. We're going to remove the watch glass from the top of our beaker and just take up a small volume. We want to use the minimum amount possible here, so we just want to start by adding about 1 milliliter to our solid. It's important that we don't heat the solid without any solvent. If we were to put it on the hot plate with no solvent in there, it could potentially burn. So we just want to add about 1 milliliter. Swirl it around, and then we can put it back onto the hot plate. We're going to want to swirl the beaker as we add additional hot solvent. So we're just taking up some more ethanol, and then adding it to our beaker in a dropwise, slow fashion. Continue to swirl the flask and look for all of our solid to dissolve. And so once all of the solid has dissolved, you are ready to begin the cooling process. So you can just remove your beaker from the hot plate. And then you want to make sure that you turn the hot plate off so that you are not continuing to heat the solvent.